Hi, this is Shiva Rajaya from vitalcoaching.com. The topic for this video is self-referencing within coaching session. I'm talking to coaches out there, people who are helping other people within the context of coaching session or therapy session sometimes. And the idea is this. It is that when you're in a coaching session, it's very important to maintain 95% of the attention on the client, on the person that you're helping. So referencing means talking about yourself as a coach within coaching sessions. For instance, your client, the person that you're helping, might say something like, I experienced something last year when I was traveling, and they tell the story, and then you step in and you're going to say something like, yeah, if I can share something with you, an experience that I had with you, that reminds me of something that happened to me many years ago. So I was traveling, blah, blah, blah. And then you start telling a story that happened to you that is a kind of mirror to their situation. So what this is going to do is it's going to take their attention away from themselves into you as a coach. And that's not a very good thing, because it's going to actually drain the energy and repolarize differently the energy of the session. So offering a little bit of self-referencing ideas every now and then, you know, maybe 5-10% of the time, a little bit here and there is okay, but making it something really central in the sessions or in your sharings or in the way you're communicating and talking a lot about yourself as a coach, about your own experience, is most of the times inappropriate, and it's going to create a kind of dissonance in the session. At least that's my experience. So for instance, if somebody shares a story that is very, you know, vulnerable on something, I might say something like, yes, I can really feel what you're experiencing. I can really relate to your experience, because at some point in the past, I experienced something similar, so I can really relate. I'm not going to go into the details of what happened. Sometimes the client will say, well, how would you handle something like that if you were exposed to the situation that I'm exposed to? Then I might, you know, tell them, I had an example or a situation that I was exposed to years ago, and this is what I did. So I will try to summarize it and condense it as much as possible, not drag the story for like 5 or 10 minutes, and keep the attention bring the attention on the client as soon as possible. So I might say, a few years ago, I was exposed to the same kind of situation in my life. And here is how I handle it. Here are the steps that I took. And so when we look back, we come back to your situation. Here is what this would mean for your situation. So it is a matter of professionalism, really, when you're engaging into a coaching session to sustain that. So the code word over here is self-referencing. Don't use it more than maybe 5-10% in a session. Keep the attention focused on your client. That's the tip number one for today. Ciao.